Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and today I'm back on rFactor 2, where we're hitting up Sebring in the LMP3 category. Now, the LMP3 car is raced in a category called the Prototype Challenge in the American sort of racing motorsport scene, and it is sort of a feeder series to the WeatherTech Sportscar Championship. Now, today I'm going to be recreating a race from that series in the Sebring sort of 1 hour and 40 minutes or however long it is, and it's going to be a little bit of a warm-up because tomorrow I'm going to be doing the actual Sebring 12 hour on rFactor. I've got a huge amount of mods that I've all sort of stashed together, and I'm going to be doing that tomorrow, so this is a little warm-up. Without any further ado, we'll jump straight into this race. Okay, so qualifying's in the books, managed to put it on the pole. However, the AI were pretty slow, so I've upped the difficulty a little bit. We've got 25 AI cars in total. The race is going to be 27 minutes or 26 minutes. I can't remember what I set it to, but approximately sort of half of what a driver would do in this race in real life. But anyway, without any further ado, we'll set off on this formation lap. Is a rolling start, of course, so we'll get to lead the charge down into turn one. Alrighty, here we go around the last corner at Sebring for what is a 26 minute race on rFactor 2 in the LMP3 car, and sort of recreation of the prototype challenge. Here we go. Green flags out, good jump. Just get to an early lead, see if we can hold it. Cold tyres, very cold tyres, very cold tyres. Cold tyres and a full load of fuel. God, this thing's hard to drive. Woo, squirrely. Right, into the hairpin. I can never get my braking right this corner. Mate, this is a handful. Didn't get too much practice in. I've been focusing more on the accurate DPI this week. So, this thing's just a boat right now. Come on. Right, head forward, come on. Try and keep this guy behind us. I think I may have turned the AI up a little bit too much. Okay. The more challenging, the better. Alright, now this last corner is probably the bumpiest corner in all of world motorsport. This is actually ridiculous. So, you got a on this mod, hit the inside line and not run the middle, because in the middle there is an almighty bump, and as you can see, I've got a little bit too shallow. He's gonna run. In fact, probably go as far as to say this is probably the bumpiest track, like track in all motorsport. But it's fun. We love it. Bitch to set up a car for, though. Seems to be good through the first sector. It's just this hairpin and the rest of the lap that we're crap. Ah, there goes the bottom of the car. that curb. So hard to get this thing around these corners in the right manner. Just keep missing the line, turning points, braking, everything. Also, it's changing it every single lap as this tyre wears away and the fuel wears down. Oh, there's that bump I was talking about. See, it just pushes you out. Ooh, it's hot. This is a handful. Behind us. Oh, that was way too deep. It's so hard to get this thing rotated. I don't know if it's, I mean, wheelbase is that long. Big move. He had a look. I need a fan in here. Feel this Florida sun beaming through the monitor. Right, how are we looking? We got 20 minutes left. God. Races always seem to go so much longer when you're in the lead. I don't know what it is. Back behind is catching me and this guy. We have a train of cars here in a second. Just cannot make a mistake. Having to focus now. Gotta get this last corner right. Keep screwing it up. The entry, the exit, you just sort of floor it and hope it ramps up and goes, but just can't get the entry right. just turning in a little bit too early into that hairpin. Need to hold that brake a little bit longer, wait and turn in, try and sort of V the exit. Better lap. Let's go. Ooh, man, it's getting hot in here. Go, so just about halfway there. These guys have been stuck behind us the entire time. Just cannot make a mistake. Soft on entry there. I said no mistakes, come on. my days. It is getting really hot in here. This is really hard work. Need him to stop fighting behind us, that would be really helpful. Oops, I apologize. Hey, why am I apologizing? It's AI. That was kind of dirty. Anyway. Yeah, I wiped out second and third. Fed him a bit of the right rear and oops. Anyway, focus ahead. It's done, it's done. Come on, Joseph. It's slow. Only 10 minutes to go. Definitely receiving a black and white for that. Burton-Harris to the stewards room. They caught up fast, damn. slow. Left. Sector, come on. It's just this second sector that screws me over. We have got a trade of cars behind us. I'm really falling off the pace here. The tyres are wearing away, I'm getting slower, and the AI seems to stay the same. Bad run onto the stretch. Sorry, the back stretch. If you call this a back stretch. This is hard work, man. So we pretty much nailed this entire lap up to that point. Man, this has been hot. Better lap. Still not quick enough. got definitely two laps to go this time around. Just gotta get this hairpin right. Last lap, come on. Let's get sweaty. Actually, no, that's it. Oh, that was the last lap. Oh, all right. Well, we grabbed the win in the end. Oh, my gosh. Man, I am sweating bullets. That was really tough work. This track on this car, or this car on this track, I should say, is an absolute handful. Woo! Mamma mia. This Florida sun is hot. All right, well. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. Stay tuned for more rFactor 2 action as we hit up the Sebring 12-hour. That's going to be tomorrow. And we're going to be driving, as I said, the Penske Acura DPI. Now, hopefully, we go as good as what we've just done in that. All right, guys, until tomorrow. I'll catch you guys later.